Yeah, are you recording?
Mm-hmm.
Well, you should have told me that you was ready. You do too much.
Hello?
Tanya.
Yeah, what's up?
I'm contacting you about the premiere party for On the Inside Looking In.
Yeah, what's going on?
I'm wanting to talk to you about, you know, where we are, given the fact that the premiere party is scheduled to launch next month. Next month starts, what, on tomorrow?
No, next month starts on Saturday.
Well, even still, today is Thursday. We really don't have a lot of time, Tanya, in reference to this party, given the way that I'm wanting the party to be. You know, I haven't even gotten my guest list together. I don't know who I'm going to invite to the premiere party. I don't, you know, after talking to Mama, she's feeling like, you know, that it shouldn't be at my house, that it needs to be off-site at a venue. That throws a wrench in things because I hadn't even considered looking outside. I don't even know where to start with finding a venue.
Okay. Now, based on what you just said, first of all, we got to figure out how many people you want there. You know what? How many people you going to deal with? You know, to be at the premiere party.
You know,
how far are you dealing with?
You know what? I was actually thinking, since Aunt Vara and April are a part of the cast, I was thinking it would even be a good idea to allow them to invite, say, 5 people or 6 people that night at the party, and that will help with the guest list.
Okay. If they're inviting, say, 6 people apiece, okay, that's 12 people right there. So the total number, if you're allowing them to have, go with the max you stated, 6 each, which is 12, the 2 of them, which will be 14, okay, how many people you want to get? Do you want 20 people there? Do you want 50 people there? Or do you have a number?
In other words, I'm feeling in my heart and gut, I'm feeling a good 40. I'm feeling a good 40 would be our base to work with, and given that a good 40, because this is not only, you know, involving me, that would be celebratory for them as well, and I'm sure they got people in their circle that they would want to celebrate with.
Okay, so we're working with the number 40. All right, now, the venue would have to be, because I know you're going to serve food, even though you haven't came up with a menu yet, so the venue would have to be large enough. You want to invite, to me, this is how I would look at, invite 60 for 40 to show up.
Exactly. That's why, you know, the Club Sugar Ray's, we don't have to use the bar, or would that be a requirement to use that venue?
Well, it may be if they charge you. If they don't charge you, then they take everything from the bar. But no, you don't have to use the bar.
I mean, because in other words, it would be a party for celebratory. I wouldn't need their bar for alcohol. It's not like I'm having a party per se. I'm having a launch party, unless my idea of a premiere party is different. Then you tell me. I don't see where I would need an alcohol bar to have this type of party.
Now, let me say this to you. The people that you invite, some of them do drink. If they see that bar there, then they will want to have something to drink. And when you use the word, quote unquote, party, some people think about a nice cold drink.
Well, let me say this right here. You do not have to have alcohol just because you use the word party. I don't drink, and everybody that's coming there, if I'm not serving alcohol, if that's what's making them come, then stay home. We ain't got to have alcohol just because we use the word party.
I mean, and you're right what you're saying. Calm down, folks. You're right. But that's just me thinking about it. And you're right, but see.
In other words, let me say this right here. In other words, my idea or caliber of business-minded people are not alcoholics. It's not like the Christmas party that we had where J.R. Neal was twisting us off the cap. I'm not talking about that type of setting. I'm talking about like-minded individuals that's coming together to network, to expand or benefit them in their business or aspirations that they have going on. I'm not talking about no party where we sitting down tossing it and twisting it. yeah, we're going to celebrate, but at the same time, classy celebration. I don't have to have the most I would probably serve would be wine.
There's nothing wrong with that. But, I mean, you don't have to have none of that if you don't want to. But I think, if I may be wrong, but I think Sugar Ray charges, back then it was $200.
Do you have a contact for these people? I mean, ain't nothing going on out there, Club Sugar Ray. They ought to be glad somebody still want to go out there and use the place.
No, their number is in the book. It is in the phone book.
Okay, so you pretty much telling me to look it up.
Basically, I have no more.
Oh, okay. Well, let me call you back.
Okay.
All right. I'm just America. Fans. Let me hold this, honey. Let me talk to my fans right now. Fans, I need for y'all to come on in the room and send up timber for the diva. Because the diva is feeling a little down right now because the diva is supposed to be having this premiere party and there's nothing is going right. Nothing is going right. Oh, God. Israel. I'm tired of y'all a little later.